Welcome to our Thrill Studio, and I'm Anuja. Today we are going to create a beautiful picture, Ram, Lakshman, Sita, along with her friends. So here I have taken an A3 size paper, which is 170 GSM. I'm using black waterproof ink from Camel and the drawing nib and the holder. If you are not comfortable with the ink and holder and handling of the nib, you can use a waterproof pen where you can draw with the pen. Here I have outlined a little just to place my figures, and now I will create it in the final form in front of you. So without any further delay, let's get started. Here I will make first the face and then we will start. So a nose, small lips and the chin. It's the side face. Eyes will be very, very big as we see in the Madhubani. Small lips and the hairstyle. Generally for the men, we do the kundals or the hoops and not the jhumkas. So we just create that way. And we have to just make the prince dress and his body. I'm making his bow and the hand, and we will decorate the full picture. So now this is the basic form of my Ram. Now I can go ahead and do the double lining and the intricate details in it. All the jewelry, all the design on the dress. So we do the double outline to differentiate between the areas that we will color. So I will be doing it in the Bharani form, and I'm creating the designs and later I will be coloring it. So this is a big sun god, because he was a Suryavanshi, maybe that's why I just chose it to be. And this way we are going to do the double outline for all the body parts and the dresses. Whichever portion you want to highlight, you can do the double outlining. You can also use a uniball pen if you're not comfortable with the ink and the nib. So this is the dhanush, and now I will make his quiver and full of arrows. Now this is Lakshman. We will follow the same. His hairstyle is a little broad and hair are back, just to differentiate a little between the two. So one side I'm making Ram and Lakshman, and the other side I'll make the group of girls. Now this is the basic, just a outline. Now this is the Sita. Her head is a little tilted because showing the shyness, and a little big elaborate jhumka. Now you can go ahead and design the dress whichever way you want it to be. Generally we put a flower, lots of jewelry, dupatta, all the embellishments, beautiful bangles to make the girls. With a little of the practice, you will get the hang of how to create your own design. Maybe you can get inspired from any of the pictures, but you can create your own style of picture. You can go elaborate very heavy on the jewelry or light as your wish be. Occasionally you have to clean up your nibs because it tends to dry, then ink tends to dry in the middle, and then it is difficult. If you are liking my video or the drawing, please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon so that you get notifications for my further uploads. Also write to me in the comments if in case you have any doubt or you need any elaborate discussion on any topic. I would love to help you out. Now these three are the side faces, and now this is the front face. This is one of a friend or the companion, and the jura, and covered with the dupatta. First, we have to visualize what you want to make so that we do not, when the figures are coming very close, they don't get overlapped. So we know that which part of which one is going at the background and which one is in the front. So simultaneously, I'm making because the third one is coming in the front. So these are just simple single outlines, single lines. But later I will be doing the double outline and creating lots of designs. So please keep watching. This is just a single line, which is not the Madhubani type. But then definitely you have to draw first and then you can go ahead and create your design. So now these are my figures, and now I am doing the background of the Vatika or the garden where they first saw each other. So this is the tree trunk and the branches and the sub branches. There's no set pattern for the branches or the sub branches. You can just accommodate yourself comfortably wherever the space is sufficient. You can just maneuver and put your branches and sub branches. The main goal for the picture is like we have to cover all the spaces and not too much of the background will be left vacant. Now here we start the designing. We get different types of nibs. There are many calligraphy nibs also. Many people get confused with calligraphy nibs and the drawing nibs. So calligraphy nibs have a little flat tip, whereas drawing nibs are very pointed. So it's, if you want really broad lines, then you have to go for a bigger number on the nib. I prefer using a drawing nib, which is G nib number 3. Now you can decorate the tree trunks. They are decorated, they are painted, and make different designs. Now creating different bands, doing some design and leaving the trunk at few places. I will be doing the bands of the design. You can go with the same design throughout or you can change it in different bands. It's totally up to your wish. So here I have changed a little in the next band. Here this is my little cute bird, and it's a pair, just to show a little, creating a mood in the picture. So this is my beautiful peacock, and I will go ahead and fill all the background with the leaves. Here designing their dresses. Generally Madhubani has lots of bright colors, and we will go ahead and color the picture in very very bright colors. So while we are drawing the dress or the designing of the dress, we kind of visualize what color should we put in, and does it, if there is no design, whether the picture will look pale and blank. So if we need to add some more color, let's do some contrast and make few design patterns. So here, that's how these pleats and different forms are created. So I'm choosing a plain pattern for the boys, for the Ramchandra and the Lakshman, and I will do small motifs and beauties, beautiful small prints for the ladies. So this is all the head accessories in the hair. I'm just making the eye, the upper lid of the eye, very heavy so that it gives life to the face and brightens up the expressions, creating a border for the dupatta and design for the lehenga. You can do whichever design you want. I'm just creating whatever comes in my mind, because basically the rough sketch you can pencil it out with, or you draft it with the pencil before, but these details come simultaneously. When we do it with the nib, you have to be very careful as to when you are dealing with the lower portions and you're doing it with your ink, it takes some time for it to dry. So be careful, do not put your hand on the wet portions, otherwise it will get smudged. So that is why I'm just going left, right, up, down, just maneuvering it different places so that I don't just put my hand on the wet ink. So all the tassels, latkans, small prints, laces, those things will come with the girl's picture. Some bangles, some mehndi motif, and whatever you want to do. Now this is the friend, so we'll keep it light jewelry, not more than Rita. We're just going to keep it a little simple and do the lace. So here we get the idea of how the side face and the front faces are drawn. The next video that I will be uploading is basically the study of faces altogether. So do subscribe my channel and you'll get the notification for the other one as well when it's uploaded. So this is a bigger picture on A3 size. If you want to create small ones, you can just do Ram and Sita and just limit yourself to one or two. These are full five figures. So we'll just create some base and the bushes at the back, which is the background. And I'm taking my black color to do the hair. As we do the hair, the picture just lightens up a lot. So you'll see how the colors take on the picture. All the jewelry stays white and we only do the hair black. So these beads and the flowers and everything that we have put on the hair are basically highlights and they stay white. Now, border. I'm taking really bright colors and then I will do the whole border. So it is the green and the red. And the center part, I'm just leaving it with lines. So this is how I've done the border. Now I move on to my figures. This is, I'm using the color acrylic and it's purple, violet and orange here. We use a waterproof ink so that when we are coloring the picture, the ink doesn't bleed onto the color. But in olden days when people used to do it with just the soot or the black coal of the diya or the kajal, they used to mix arabic gum or the gum that we get from the trees like babool tree or the neem tree, and they used to mix the soot in that, and then that was quite stable and doesn't mix to the other color. So that was how it was made in those times. Now we have over the counter, we have like lots of waterproof colors. Acrylic is one of them and very bright medium. So I'm using my acrylic paints to color. You can choose your desired color combinations to do the picture. The brushes I'm using are the synthetic brushes. For the places which are very, very thin, I'm using the 0 and 1. And for the broad ones, I'm using 2 and 4. Now, it totally depends on your choice of colors, whether you want it dark or light. But yeah, it is the contrast that matters. So I just kind of stick to the contrast. Now, this is the face part, and what I have done is I have taken the flesh tint color. Flesh tint or the skin color that we call, and I have diluted it into what in with little bit of water. When we dilute it with water, our strokes, our brush lines are not very obvious and they blend very nicely before it dries. And now I'm just adding a little darker shade to, but I mix a little bit of brown and create a darker shade and do the little lines in the crease, so to get the warm effect on the face and not very chalky one. You can follow my tutorial and do the drawing. Do share your drawings with me and I will be sharing it on the page itself. So here I'm doing the leaves in light color and the background in the dark color. And this is how the whole picture comes. It's brighten up. The tree trunks will alternate with bright colors and the brown, which is the wood color. So this is the brown, and now I'm coloring all the details with whatever color I wish to do. You can also leave black and white lines. That also looks equally pretty. So for both the prints, we are just started with their dress. The ground, I'm picking up gray because that will create a little contrast from the green. I could have done green as well, but then it'll mix. So you have to be a little clever on choosing on what color we are picking. If we are picking the same shade of green, everything will turn green. So we have to go and think wisely what shade we can choose for, if it's dark or light. Now here on the ground, I am creating few broken lines to give it a little more detailed and a grainy look on the ground. Some places when you will see that while painting, you disturbed or kind of covered the line, the black line, you can redo the black line and then it will come beautifully. So this is how my picture is done after doing few creepers hanging, and all the picture is created like this. I hope you like it. So do not wait. Pick up the pencil and paper and start to draw. I hope I inspired you a little to pick the pencil and try the Madhubani form of pictures. Thanks for watching.